My whole life, I've had a desktop computer. It was great. Ah, the memories. You can fix it if it breaks. You can upgrade it. But as I got older and had kids, all of a sudden there's no more room for my bulky setup. So I knew I wanted to make a YouTube channel, and I like doing a bit of gaming and photo editing. I needed something small yet capable. My budget was around 1300 US, which is a lot, but it isn't a huge budget considering I wanted my laptop to be capable of somewhat competitive gaming, 4K video production, I wanted a long battery, I wanted a nice bright screen, I wanted it to feel like a premium product, I wanted it to have a nice keyboard and mouse pad. I felt like one of those people on those property shows. Yes, I make banana peel art, and my wife, she makes armor for pet tarantulas. We want our own private island. We have $43,000 to spend. What I wanted seemed unreasonable for the price I was willing to spend. With all of my boxes ticked, I was looking at $3,000 Razorblade laptops. Oops. Man, those sure looked sick though. This was back in 2020, and my tech buddy was like, "Yo, Evs, AMD launched this chip that is crushing Intel, bro." Eventually, it led me down the path where I heard of the Asus Zephyrus line of laptop. I was familiar with Asus, and the more I looked into it, it was ticking all my boxes, and the price was a lot less than the Razer. It was sounding too good to be true. So I YOLO'd and bought the G15 Zephyrus. I've had it for almost a year. Is it any good? Should you buy one? Let's find out right now. In this video, I'm not going to be doing any benchmark or comparison tests. I just want to talk about if you should buy one and whether or not I'm happy with my purchase as someone who has owned decent computers my whole life. Also, this review is from a 2020 model, but I think this video still represents the newer versions. Last year's tech is still so sick. So don't think this video isn't worth watching if you are considering the 2021 or newer versions of the Zephyrus lineup. Here's what I loved. The Zephyrus, it has a premium feel. This version isn't completely metal, although the outside of the lid is, and it feels quality and sturdy. The plastic around the keyboard doesn't feel cheap. I like using it. Speaking of the keyboard, it feels nice to the touch and has a satisfying sound while typing. My one isn't RGB, but it does light up, which is nice. I ended up getting the 240Hz screen. Damn, this screen is sick. I'm not sure if anyone needs 240Hz. I play Hearthstone, and the animation speed on it feels incredible. In fact, I hate playing it now on anything else because of the frames per second. FPS for life. Other games look incredible on here as well. The colors are nice, it's a matte screen. I edit photos and do some color grading, and it's good. It's only a 1080p screen though. I wanted 4K, but on a 15-inch screen, what's the point, really? It has a fast processor when it's plugged in. Having direct power, this thing is fast like a desktop. It's crazy. It goes as fast as I go, which is nice. Love the processor. I can't speak for the Intel versions, but the new AMD stuff, incredible. The graphics card. The model I have has the RTX 2060. It can handle ray tracing. This thing has handled every game I've thrown at it. And while it can get loud and hot, if you are rocking headphones or have a lap desk, who cares? I also would not have it directly on my lap when you're playing games, as you might burn your nuts off. Again, the lap desk helps for that. For the latest AAA games, you might have to run them on medium, but again, anytime you can get over that 100 frames per second, the screen just feels so good and responsive. I used to play 4K gaming on my GTX 1080 on my desktop, but the frames per second at a lower resolution, that high refresh rate, it's better. Now, one of the most important reasons why I got this laptop, I can video edit in 4K. That's pretty ridiculous. Look, I can't say I've tried these programs on 10 other machines, but it does this nicely, which I think is incredible. I can render a 6-minute video in about 5 minutes. That's gnarly a laptop can do that without melting. My old desktop that had that GTX 1080 in it, it also had a 7th generation i7, and that would take about 15 minutes to render the same video. The laptop annihilates it. Now, the battery life is also great. It can last quite a while too. If you pop on the subreddits, some people are making tweaks and getting 10 hours plus of use on it. I don't really get that much, but I haven't really tweaked it, and I like it a bit more high performance when I'm using it for my needs. So it gets ample time for watching Netflix and browsing. If you wanted to go do some work remotely at a coffee shop, this thing should last you long enough. Here's what it's missing, or where I think it lacks. The brushed metal on the lid can get smudgy. It looks cool enough, but if you're using it in public, people might think you're a bit greasy. I don't care. It has no SD card slot. Since I am a content creator, this one sucks a bit. However, I can use one of these, and it's not a big deal. But still, who wants to carry around a bag full of dongles? The screen, while nice, I do wish it got a little bit brighter. It's enough, but I just wish just a little. As mentioned, it has no RGB keyboard. If I was younger, maybe I'd care more, but I'm staring at the screen most of the time anyways. I barely notice. Mine has no camera built in. Some people might think this is a benefit, but in the time of Zoom calls, etc., it's inconvenient. I wouldn't have minded a built-in camera. Lastly, it gets hot and it's pretty loud under pressure. I mean, this thing can run AAA games well. It has to get hot because that's insane. It would be great if it wasn't so hot. Playing this on your lap in the summertime would be super uncomfortable. Should you buy a Zephyrus laptop? I'm still happy with the 2020 and enjoy using this thing thoroughly. So whether you buy the 2020, 2021, 2022 in the future, the quality should remain consistent to what I have experienced. I want this video to say that even though you can get the latest version with the newer chip, last year's one is still bananas. So yes, you should buy a Zephyrus laptop. Even last year's model for the right price is still a beautiful, very capable machine that I'm sure most people will be happy with. If money isn't an issue, I mean, I would probably rather have a Razer Blade, but having bought this, I'm not unhappy with my purchase. I'm very happy. For the price point, mamma mia. Why'd I do that? I'm not Italian. What a capable machine. This thing shreds. If you haven't considered the Zephyrus lineup, you should. You get premium feel with incredible performance at a reasonable price. Do I miss my desktop? I mean, I always will. Hopefully I can have one again, but for now, this little thing is keeping a smile on my face. What are you doing?
I'm pwning some noobs, Dan.
You're pwning noobs. Nice. Did you get lethal?
I actually almost do.
Ooh.
How did you do that?
Well, that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate all the comments, thumbs up, and new follows. See you next time on the Sad Life.